Jar J. What's it, Nate? Put your shades on. Kingdom style. And let's go.
Welcome to my world.
I prefer this last style better. Now I'm changed like too fast for a tenner. I've been around the block, I've been around the city block. And I know that I'm staying sitting on the rock. I seen a few brothers drop. They can't afford to buy diamonds, so the soul rocks. But that's not my port.
T or your Lola? He is, he manages people like Governor B, he manages Eddie Kadi, and he doesn't like being on camera. But I really need to get him. He's running away, so you're gonna have to pretty much run up.
So I feel that his orders, therefore I'm gonna make it. Call me in the fifth corner. Through the king, my life is fine, cause Christ set me free like a squirrel.
It was good, man, it was good. You're the man. Stop running away from camera. Stop running away from camera. Stop running away from camera. What? Are you camera shy?
I'm a behind the scenes kind of guy.
Well, everything you've been doing behind the scenes is now coming in the front light. What's going on, people? It's your boy Michael. You're watching OTV. It's all good. Keep it locked. So you're in the spotlight?
No, the artists are in the spotlight. Eddie Kadi, 4th of September, O2 Arena, OTV, Michael Owusu.
He's a top promoter, trust me. See, you've been doing some amazing things in the UK scene. Both in the gospel, you know, you're doing Governor B. You just helped to put together T3M. You're doing some really amazing things. You manage Yolanda Brown. You're managing Eddie Kadi. This is, like, I'm amazed. When I grow up, I want to be like you. Do you know what I'm saying? When I grow up, I want to be like you. Listen, I'm going to take you back. This is one-to-one show style. How did you begin?
How did I begin? I started a few years ago. Believe it or not, I used to be a singer. Or I believed I was a singer.
What?
For many years.
Oh, you're going to give us a line.
That's not going to happen. Then I heard my voice for real one day and I retired. prior to that, I used to play drums. Grew up in church playing drums from the age of 12. And I always knew there was a space somewhere in entertainment for me. I just didn't know where. The management I kind of fell into. I met Eddie in uni. Eddie was like the funniest guy on campus. And I said to Eddie, I was like, why don't you try stand-up? And he was like, no way, you can never get me in front of an audience selling jokes, you know. And a few years later, a few persuasions later, he went for it and did his first comedy show. And it was amazing, you know, he got a standing ovation and he hasn't really looked back since, you know. So, yeah, that's how we all started managing Eddie. Met Yolanda Brown, started managing her as well, Governor B, and it's been amazing since.
Yeah.
That's Bashy, by the way. Amazing artist.
Yeah.
And Becky, Eddie's PR. We just ran off to Starbucks for their 70th meal.
He likes to promote everyone.
So yeah, started managing the artist from there. In the midst of all that, I was organizing events, and that was also another love of mine. So that's Eddie, by the way.
Eddie, I need you in front of the camera.
Just to get me involved. Okay, my Eddie TV people, I'm going to speak to you later because we've got Michael Owusu here.
Yeah, that's right.
He's like the man, like the next Ghanaian president. Bye.
Eddie, come on my right. Come on my right. This is one-to-one show. I was asking T. T, don't run away.
Okay,
I'm here. We got security here. All right. I was just asking T how he got his start because T's been doing some amazing things. He's a man, you like to be discreet. You don't like to be in the spotlight, which is really cool. But he's doing some amazing things. He was just telling us a minute ago how he met you at uni and you were doing that. Since when did you actually decide? Let me rephrase that. Did you ever decide that you wanted to be a stand-up comedian?
That's a very good, I've never heard someone rephrase in a better way. Yes, because it wasn't my decision. It wasn't my decision, Michael. I was there minding my own business, talking as I always do, talking to myself. You know, I didn't know people found anything that I said was funny. And a few of my friends, mainly T, decided that I would go on stage. Now, if you're looking at T right now, you will be slightly intimidated. So when he suggested that Eddie go on stage, I said no. He said, Eddie, go on stage. I said no. He said, Eddie. I said yes. But no, on a serious note, you know, it's a beautiful journey from where I started, you know, just having fun at university, as most people do. Being the person that I am, I did, you know, kind of always like performing, but not to this kind of level. You know, I never thought I'd get to this level. And T was one of the few people who obviously believed in what I did and encouraged me to go on stage. And the stage just seemed to be getting bigger and bigger. I believe the stage probably did start in my parents' living room. My family home, at that moment in time, I think I was very naive, probably a 3-year-old guy wanting just milk. Aww. and puff puff. And then eventually you get to primary school. I was in the school choir, but you know, you had to do it because it's
so what, you both sang? We need to get you two to do a duet.
You know what? I sang because I had to. T sang because he thought the world
was.
I sang because I was happy.
Yeah, I think comedy is definitely your one.
But yeah, no, that's a sign. I can sing every song in past tense. Yeah?
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Hello. Is it me you was looking for? And I wondered where you were. I wondered how you did.
You guys stay tuned. I'm coming back right with T and Eddie Kadi. Stay tuned.